My name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other videos where you was learning about the SCCM, that the series name is the SCCM tutorial. Okay, so this video is about the discovery, how the discovery is running in SCCM. So first question is like, why we need the discovery? So discovery is the method to discover the machines from your infrastructure, and by using the discovery, machine will discover and it will keep it into SCCM. Okay, so let's see how the discovery will work. Before that, I will show you in the device. I have the two machines, and when I will be running the discovery, automatically machine will shows in the under the device and even the users also. So in under the users, I don't have any machines here. So let's go to the option where the discovery will be there. Under administrator hierarchy discovery method. So here we are having these many discoveries. So we'll go with the one by one how the discovery will work. Okay, so this is the first discovery. It's a Active Directory forest discovery. So what is the meaning of forest? It's the top of domain hierarchy in your infrastructure. Like you are having 2-3 domains, and the top of there is a other domain is there, means the top domain called like a forest domain. So when we are using this discovery under that domain, everything will be discovered in our SCCM console. So let's see this option how it will work. So if I am enabling this here, it's not asking any other information. Why? Because when my SCCM was I was installing my SCCM, I given the domain name, so automatically taking the domain name once.com, and under that domain all the child domain automatically it will discover and it will give you the information about the group, security groups, machines, user, and everything it will discover automatically. Okay, to be enable this, select this option, enable the forest discovery, and when you want to this is the automatically create the Active Directory sites. Okay, so when you are running this discovery, you will be having some AD sites under your AD. So these will automatically discover and add it to your SCCM. If you select it, it will discover all the sites and it will put it into your SCCM. Now the second thing, automatically create IP address. So this this intelligence will work when under the forest, whatever IP ranges you have given or the subnets you have given, all the subnets automatically it will discover and come to your SCCM. Okay, so and the scheduling whenever you want, like every hour, every day or every week to run your the forest discovery. Okay, so if you run it, actually I don't want to run. If I run it, then the entire things will be discovered and I cannot show you the other option. I will show you the at last. So the next discovery is the group discovery. So group discovery is like where we are discovering our security groups. Like Active Directory is under that having some security groups which by default is created, or we have customized that group. If we want to discover that groups, we can use this discovery. So select this option to enable, and I will show you how we can do that. So this is the group. Here I can give the group discovery name like SCCM I given, and here is if you are if you want to some discovery from some specific domain, you can put it here, or if you want to use the default domain what is configured in your SCCM, you can use this. Okay, so now browse here and let me go to the security, because I don't remember what how many groups I have. So these are the groups I have here, and the groups like the domain user. Okay, so let me select this. And this is the option, use the site server account, or if you want to use any other different account, you can use it here. Now click OK. This part is done. And if you want to add one more, you can go and you can add it one more group. No, it's a polling scheduling. What is the polling scheduling? Means is like to run this discovery automatically, we are setting up a time. On that particular time, this discovery will run and will get the data in my SCCM. This is the option for the delta. Why delta discovery is required? Because when by selecting this option, this AD discovery will not run a full discovery. It will discover only the minor changes happen in your AD. And these are the some more options, like only discover computer that logged on. What is that meaning is, it will discover only that computer which is logged in last 30 days, 60 days or 90 days. You can give the time range here. So it will work based on the AD last logon time. It will check in that AD machine last logon when it was login. If it is not login in within 30 days, so it will not discover. If it is a last logon time more than 30 days, it will not discover. Under the 30 days only, it will discover. So discover the computer account given the period time since the password was updated. Okay, so it's something like a when your the password was updated, or to check that, and if it is not updated password last 90 days, more than 90 days, so it will not discover. So usually the company are using 30 days or the 45 days to change the password. Okay, so discover the membership of the distribution group. Okay, so if you want to discover that distribution group also, you can select it here. So this option was for the group discovery. Okay, so let me run this now. Click OK, click here, and you can right click and run the full discovery. Now we'll check the logs file whether it's running or not. So this logs name will be Active Directory ADS SG Group Discovery. So here is, we can see in it 8:56 p.m. and this my discovery is run successfully. Now I will check where this information is stored in our SCCM. So click here and go to the users. So guys, before starting this video, in starting this video, I showed you here there was no any users and group was here. Okay, so when I was running this my group discovery, then my group also came here, and the all the users, whatever under this group user was there, all the users automatically came here. So if you want to see that properties, you can see it here. And my all the users, I'm using AD users, administrator, SSEM, SEPM, and the SQL users. So all the SQL discovery here, and that group what I was defining in group discovery, that group also came here. Okay guys, hope so this option is very much clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can comment me. I will explain you much and more here. So now the next discovery is system discovery. Okay, so before going this, I will show you something here. In my device, there is only two machine, SSCM and SSCMDP. So when I will be running this my system discovery, all the machines will extract from AD and it will come to my devices. So let's use this discovery, that is name is the system discovery. Now double click and enable this, select this option, and now you will get the OU name. So which OU want to discover here? So now here is, I am selecting like the servers. In the Windows I don't have any machines, so servers I selected, and you can say discover within the group. Use the computer account, so it will use to discover that machine on your SCCM account. It will use, if you want to use any other account, like if your account is not having access on that particular group, so you can use the another account. But obviously, if you are running the SCCM info, you should have the access there. Now click here. So I have added one OU, Now, polling scheduling, as I explain you in that before some time back, polling scheduling is at what time we want to run this discovery. So automatically it will run the discovery, and the same as a delta, in how many minutes I want to discover my the delta machine. Like my I added one or two machines in AD recently. So that machine will discover in SCCM based on my delta discovery. So it will, so we should not wait till this full discovery will run. Now, Active Directory attributes. Okay, what is the attribute? Attribute is called like a property. So on your machine, what kind of thing you want as a property? Like the machine name is there, last logon is there, or any other thing. So there are the so many attributes are there. If you want some more attributes, you can select it. Okay, so by default attributes are there. I think it's more than enough to select the attributes. If you want to add some more attributes, more properties, you can select it here. Okay, so this is the option here. So this option is, as I explained earlier, it will discover that machine which is last logon 90 days, 30 days or 40 days. So it will be bound your last logon. So based on your last logon also you can discover your machine. Okay guys, so this setting is done. Now let me click OK, and it's asking, do you want to run the full discovery as soon as possible? Yes, I want to run it. Let me check the logs file. So this is my the logs file, AD sys discovery. So when we are running our system discovery, we have to check this log whether everything is going right or not. So if this discovery is run the successfully, you will get like a message, successfully updated directory search. So discovery is successfully sync up. Okay guys, so remember this log. So whenever you are running, you can open this log and check whether your discovery is running or not. Now we'll go to the SCCM and we'll see where the machine came. So it discovered. Wow, so my machine is discovered and now came to in the SCCM. So here is a SCCM, SCCM DP. These two machines already it was discovered, and these are the other machine. Four more machines are added in my after running this discovery. Okay guys, so this is how you can use your the system discovery, and you can check the logs. If there is any error, then only you can troubleshoot. Now we'll see the another discovery. Go to again under the discovery, and it is a user discovery. Okay, so let me go back first in users. If I'm running this discovery, how you will identify? Let me delete few users here, and I will show you how the users will discover here. Okay, so here I am having only two group, AD and the administrator, two users only. And now I will use my the Active Directory user discovery. Okay, so click here, it will enable, and let me add the groups here. So I have the users. I have not created the customized users. By default I am using. Give your the user group name, and you can select these option like the under that group inside. Okay, use the account. Now again it's a polling. I explain you what time you want to schedule it and the attributes. Okay, so this part is done. Let me run this. Run as soon as possible. Yes, I want to run it now itself, and I can go again to my logs folder, and the logs folder will be AD user discovery is here, and let me check out whether the discovery is run or not. So now just now it's run. Is the sync up returning 00 means without any error my discovery completed. And from where it was discovered, let's see more into logs. So it's taken this path is like the, no, this is
was running. Let me go to starting logs. Yeah, so it has started from here. Here is SMS executable, SMS underscore executable start SMS AD discovery. Okay, so this service is triggered to discover the AD user discovery. Now it is started. Now then what next date? Okay, scheduling is the control file is, file ID is this. So which type I am running? It's a full synchronization scheduled. I was running a full synchronization. If it is a delta, it will come like a delta name. The valid search from where it will search. So this is the my LDAP path. From here it will search like under users I am discovering. So here it's showing starting the data discovery. And then it start discovery and it collecting the details. As it is a full discovery, entire things it will check. And finally, it's given the exit code 0, returning with a 00, and it got successful. And here also you can see it successfully completed directory search. So that's how we can read the logs file. Now we'll go to our SCCM and we'll see where this content available. So users, here it's came. So in the before some time back, I deleted these three users from my SCCM and now it discovered by the user discovery. So if there is something account by mistakenly deleted or any machine by mistakenly deleted, you can run the discovery, automatically it will come to your SCCM. Okay guys, so hope so this part also clear to you. Now the next point is in network hardware discovery. So hardware discovery, it should be enabled all time. The first thing, when the client is installed, like I'm not using any method to deployment, like through SCCM I'm installing a client on the end user machine, but I'm using manual installation. So after the manual installation, client will have some the like a hardware discovery. So it will try to search their MP and the SCCM server, that called a hardware discovery. Every hour, mostly it's set up like a every hour when the client was trying to search to MP and the SCCM server. Okay, like suppose I deleted few machines in my SCCM and then how it will come again. So after some time when the hardware discovery will run, then automatically then machine will come to my SCCM. Okay, so now the next option is a network discovery. So what is the network discovery? Network discovery is basically used for the OSD part, OS operating system deployment. Why? Because by using this discovery, we will discover only the network. It will not discover any the resource like users and the system. It will discover your IP address are using in your network infrastructure. Okay, so in OSD, how we can use it? When we are deploying any OS, that means suppose we take in a laptop, it's a bare metal machine where there is a no OS. No OS means it's not having any host name and like it's not having the entry in the Active Directory because there is a no operating system. So in this situation, what we'll do, we'll run the network discovery and it will search how many machines are connecting in the network. So when you connected your bare metal machine in the network, it will search that IP and it will give it to you in your SCCM. Then you can target the particular machine and deploy the OS. That's how it is working. So here is a few terminology like on what basis it will discover that machine. So option is like, let me enable this. like a topology and client, topology, client, and the operating system. So you can select it, any of this, whichever you fishable, like, okay, I will get the more information. So here is a subnet. So it's a very important part for the network discovery. So when we are discovering network, we should know that the subnet, because IP address we cannot give here. We need the subnet. In this subnet, how many machines are there available in the network that will search through the subnet base only. So if I'm giving a subnet here, in that subnet how many IP address will be there, and that IP address is connected somewhere, like on the LAN cable, printer connected, or anything, it will discover based on your subnet. Now here is a domain. So based on the domain also you can search, like under this domain how many machines network is working, you can add it here. SNMP, it's I have not configured in my lab. SNMP, DHCP also I have not configured. If you configure the DHCP, you can give the IP range here. Sorry, DHCP server name, I think. Yeah, DHCP server name. Scheduling is the same like the last time I showed you the polling schedule. So it will work in the same way as a polling schedule. What time you want to discover, what time you want to run your network discovery. Okay, so guys, in this video you learn about the all type of discovery, and thank you for watching this video. So see you soon in my next video.